Hello everyone, in this video lecture I'll be explaining about principal instrumentation and application of flame photometry and atomic absorption spectroscopy. Flame photometry was developed in 1980 by the three scientists Barnes, David and Robert, who developed an instrument to measure the low concentration of sodium and potassium in a solution. They named this instrument as flame photometer. The flame photometer is based on determination of concentration of an element in a solution by measuring the intensity of characteristic radiation emitted to the flame by the element. So let's start up with the principle of flame photometry. When a solution containing a metal salt solution is aspirated into the flame, following changes are seen. First, the solvents get evaporated, leaving behind the salt in the flame. Next, the vaporization of salt takes place, followed by dissociation to give the constituent atoms into the ground state. The metal atoms formed in the flame may absorb the heat energy from the flame and may get electronically excited to the higher energy level. Being unstable at the excited level, the atoms fall back to their ground state by emitting the light radiation. The intensity of light radiation emitted impart characteristic color to the flame, and intensity of light radiation emitted to the flame is proportional to the concentration of the element present in the flame. Different metals emit their characteristic radiation at different wavelength, therefore they do not interfere with each other even when they are present together. So this is the general principle of flame photometry. Instrumentation of flame photometry. Flame photometry consists of a nebulizer, a mixing chamber, a burner to produce the flame, filter, photo detector and the readout. Let me explain the instrumentation of flame photometry in detail. Pressurized air is first passed through the nebulizer. You can see here the air, that is nothing but the pressurized air, is first passed through the nebulizer. The nebulizer sucks the sample at a controlled rate. The nebulizer creates a fine spray like droplets which passes through the mixing chamber. This is the mixing chamber where the mixing of the mixture with the LPG gas takes place. So LPG gas is supplied from the gas inlet. So here mixing of the mixture takes place. Next, it is passed through the burner where burning of the mixture takes place. The radiation from the flame passes through the lens and to the filter. The role of the filter is just to allow the specific wavelength and to absorb all other wavelengths. Next, it is passed through the photo detector. The photo detector detects the emitted light and measures the intensity of radiation emitted by the flame. The emitted radiation is converting into the electrical signal with the help of the photo detector. Next, it is amplified, processed and it's passed through the readout. So this is nothing but the instrumentation of flame photometry. Let us have a quick overview of working of flame photometry by looking at the figure 1. The metal salt is present in the solution. Example, sodium chloride can be taken as an example. So this salt is present in form of ions in the solution. So these ions are first aspirated into the flame. When these ions are aspirated into the flame, the solvent evaporates, leaving behind the salt in the flame. Next, this salt absorbs the thermal energy from the flame and undergoes thermal decomposition by splitting into constituent atom. So these atoms in the ground state absorb the heat energy and get excited to higher energy level. But these atoms are highly unstable at excited state. They come back into the ground state by emitting the light radiation of the characteristic wavelength. Next, the intensity of emitted radiation is proportional to concentration of the element. So this is nothing but the general working of flame photometry. In the next diagram 2, we can see the emitted wavelength and the flame colors of various alkali and alkaline earth metals. Example, potassium. The emitted wavelength is at 766 nanometer and the color of the flame seen is violet. Similarly, lithium, the emitted wavelength is 670 nanometer. The flame color seen is red. Calcium, the emitted wavelength is 622 nanometer and the flame color is orange. Similarly, sodium, the emitted wavelength is seen at 589 nanometer and the flame color is yellow. Similarly, for barium, the emitted wavelength seen is at 554 nanometer and the color of the flame is lime green. Next, we will see the applications of flame photometry. It is used in clinical field. The sodium and potassium ions in the body fluids, muscles and heart can be determined by diluting the blood serum and aspiration into the flame. It is also used in analysis of soft drinks, fruit juices and alcoholic beverages can also be analyzed by using flame photometry. The other important application is nothing but determination of elements such as alkali and alkaline earth metals. So these are some of the important applications of flame photometry. Atomic absorption spectroscopy. Atomic absorption spectroscopy, also known as AAS, was first introduced by Alan Walsh in 1955. The technique is used to determine the concentration of particular element present in the sample to be analyzed. Absorption of light radiation coming from the hollow cathode lamp by the atom in the ground non-excited state and determination of intensity of that absorbed radiation with the concentration of the element is the basis of atomic absorption spectroscopy. Let us start with the principle of atomic absorption spectroscopy. When a solution containing the metal salt is aspirated into the flame, the following changes is seen. First, the solvents get evaporated, leaving behind the salt in the flame. Next, the vaporization of salt followed by dissociation to give constituent atoms into the ground state. Next, the gaseous metal atom formed in the flame may absorb heat energy from the flame and may get electronically excited to their higher energy level. But most of the metal atom remains in the ground unexcited state. So atomic absorption spectroscopy is related with the metal atom which remains in the ground unexcited state. If the light radiation of the characteristic wavelength element from the hollow cathode lamp is passed through the flame, a part of the light is absorbed by the atom present in the ground state, which in turn get excited to the higher energy level. The extent of absorption is proportional to the number of atoms present in the ground state or concentration of the solution. Thus, by measuring absorbance, concentration can be calculated. AAS follow Beer-Lambert's law, that is A equal to epsilon LC, where A is the absorbance, C is the concentration of the solution, L is the path length and epsilon is the molar absorption coefficient. Instrumentation of atomic absorption spectroscopy. Atomic absorption spectroscopy consists of following components. Hollow cathode lamp. It produces a radiation characteristics of the element under test. Example, sodium to be analyzed. The cathode is made up of sodium. If we want to calculate the concentration of lithium in the solution, then the cathode is made up of lithium. Nebulizer. It sucks up the sample at a controlled rate and creates fine spray for the introduction into the flame. The aerosol, fuel and oxidant mix thoroughly for the introduction into the flame. Next is the atomizer, also known as burner. The sample is burned into the atom in atomizer. Next is the monochromator. The monochromator is used just to select the specific wavelength of light absorbed by the sample. So it will convert the polychromatic light into the monochromatic light. Next is detector. The light selected by the monochromator is passed through the detector, which converts the light signal into the electrical signal. Recorder. The signal is finally recorded using the recorder. In this slide, the experimental setup of atomic absorption spectroscopy is given. The experimental setup can be explained in two segments. One is the hollow cathode lamp. Second part is the flame part. So first I'll be dealing with the hollow cathode lamp. So hollow cathode lamp consists of anode, cathode and a glass shield, and also this whole tube is filled with inert gas such as neon or argon. Anode is made up of tungsten. Cathode is nothing but made up of characteristic metal of interest. That is, example, if you want to estimate the amount of sodium present in the given solution, the cathode is made up of sodium. Example, if you want to estimate the amount of potassium present in the given analyte solution, the cathode will be made up of potassium. So initially, when the current is passed between anode and cathode, the inert gas which is filled here undergoes ionization and it hits the cathode. So here the metal atom present in the cathode undergoes ejection. So this is known as sputtering. The ejected cathode and the inert gas molecule will come together and collide with each other and get excited to higher energy level. Being unstable at higher energy level, the excited molecule comes into the ground state with the emission of light radiation of the characteristic wavelength. So that light radiation will be coming out from the quartz window. So this light radiation is next passed through the flame. So this is nothing but the working of hollow cathode lamp. So next let us discuss the second part, that is regarding the flame. So here the sample solution is taken here and sucked with the help of the nebulizer, which creates a fine spray like droplets, and ultimately here proper mixing takes place, and when here the air, fuel and the solution get mixed up properly and is next fed into the flame through the burner, a series of changes takes place. The solvent gets evaporated, leaving behind salt. Next, salt absorbs thermal energy from the flame, goes into vapor state and dissociate into constituent atoms. But some atoms from the flame get excited to higher energy level, but some remain in the ground non-excited state. So here in atomic absorption spectroscopy, it deals with the atom present in the ground non-excited state. The light radiation of the particular element from the hollow cathode lamp is passed through the flame which contains the atom in the ground non-excited state. Example, if you take sodium as an sample, in the sample solution, the cathode will be made up of sodium, and definitely the light radiation of 590 nanometer will be coming out from the hollow cathode lamp, which falls on the atom present in the ground non-excited state. So here what happens is nothing but the light radiation of 590 nanometer falls on the atom present in the ground non-excited state, and the atoms get excited to higher energy level. The light transmitted passes through the monochromator, which will convert the polychromatic light into monochromatic light. So here it selects the characteristic wavelength of the metal to be determined. Ultimately it passes through the detector. So here the light signal is converting into the electrical signal by the means of detector, and recorder will record the absorbance. So this is regarding the instrumentation working of the atomic absorption spectroscopy. Finally, the application of atomic absorption spectroscopy. It is used for analysis of metal ions like sodium, potassium, magnesium and calcium in the blood samples, saliva and urine sample. It is also used to estimate the amount of lead in petroleum products. It is used to determine the toxic elements such as nickel, zinc, copper in food industry.